Christ is risen today, number 540. Please stand if you are able.
We praise you, we bless you. God's Son have come to death and unlocked for us the path to eternity. Grant, we pray, that we who keep the solemnity of the Lord's resurrection may, through the renewal brought by your Spirit, rise up in the light of life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter proceeded to speak and said, "You know what has happened all over Judea, beginning in Galilee, after the baptism that John preached, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and power. He went about doing good and healing all those oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. We are witnesses of all that he did, both in the country of the Jews and in Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree. This man God raised on the third day and granted that he be visible, not to all the people, but to us, the witnesses chosen by God in advance, who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commissioned us to preach to the people and testify that he is the one appointed by God as judge of the living and the dead. To him all the prophets bear witness that everyone who believes in him will receive forgiveness of sins through his name." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, do you not know that a little yeast leavens all the dough? Clear out the old yeast, so that you may become a fresh batch of dough, inasmuch as you are unleavened. For our Paschal Lamb, Christ, has been sacrificed. Therefore, let us celebrate the feast, not with the old yeast, the yeast of malice and wickedness, but with the unleavened bread of sincerity and truth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Happy Easter! Dear friends, when we think about Easter, each one of us, each family, have certain traditions that we want to do. And we also have some expectation that something should happen during Easter. For example, for many of you on Holy Saturday, you have the tradition to bring the Easter basket to the church. So the priest can bless the Easter basket. And then the children run to the gym or in the backyard for the Easter egg hunt, and they enjoy themselves. And then the family decide what Mass we go to, and after Mass, after Easter Sunday Mass, the family have gathered together for breakfast, brunch, or lunch. The extended family and friends were invited. And we all have enjoyed the moment that we celebrate Easter, also the family reunion together. We expect that the church impacted people and everything is doing well. The environment and the society around us is so joyful. And that's our tradition and our expectation for Easter. But that is not the case for this year. All expectation or tradition or routine were turned upside down because of the coronavirus. We all stuck in our house and we are not clear about the future. We are afraid, we are confused, and we don't know about tomorrow. So for many of us, this Easter is not a good one. Or we may say that this is the bad Easter in your life. So let me tell you about my family bad Easter. Easter, before Easter of the year 1975, we were aware that the communists moving closer to my hometown. We were so afraid, we were so scared. What did we do? The whole family ran away. We abandoned our home, we left behind everything, we ran away. And then, on our journey, running away like that, we celebrate Easter. I was too young, I was too little to remember or to understand everything. But I know for sure, that's not a good Easter for my family and myself. We may not go to the church to worship God on that Easter Sunday, because we are running away. But today we celebrate Easter. Whatever happened in our life, we celebrate Easter. We celebrate the Lord risen from the dead. And we greet each other happy Easter. But how can we be happy? How can we rejoice and be glad at the sound we normally use for Easter Sunday? This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. How we can rejoice and be glad? So I would like to invite you to remember one big thing happened in the Bible. And you know that the Passion, the death and resurrection of Jesus Christ took place in the context of the Passover, the Feast of Passover, the most important feast of our Jewish brothers and sisters. Easter is the new Passover. So in order for us to understand more what is going on and what should we do during this time of Easter with everything going on, we should go back to that first Easter, the first Passover. What happened to the people of Israel? And you know that Easter Vigil Mass yesterday, we always use the reading, the Exodus story, right, to tell us the story that the Israelites run away from Egypt. On that day, when they start their journey, running away to get out of Egypt, the Egyptian army right behind them, chased them down, and they want to kill them all. The Israelites keep running, running to the point that they couldn't run anymore. They hit the wall. They go to the Red Sea, and they couldn't pass over that Red Sea. A great thing happened. The Lord made the Red Sea dry, split up, so the people of Israel can walk through the Red Sea. The Egyptian army followed them. And as soon as the last Israelite got out of that of the Red Sea, the Lord had made the water to come back and destroy totally the Egyptian family. This is the greatest miracle happened in front of the whole Israelites. They saw that, they witnessed it. They couldn't help, but they cried out in loud voice to praise the Lord. They sang the song of victory. They sang the song that the Lord saved them, liberated them, and brought them out of the darkness of slavery and death to the land of freedom. That is the Passover. But you remember that the Israelites were not in the promised land yet. They continue their journey. Their journey is very long. The Bible says it took for 40 years. It's a long journey and full of difficulties and challenges and tests in front of them. And sometimes they would walk in darkness and they didn't know where to go. But the Bible said that during the night, when the people of Israel don't know where to go, God sent to them a column of fire going in front of them to lead them, to guide them in the darkness of the night. And the people of Israel followed that fire, followed that column of fire, and they keep going, they keep journeying until the day they all enter the promised land, the land that the Lord promised to all of them. So friends, we are just like that. We celebrate the Easter. Yes, at the Passover event, the Lord destroyed the power of the Egyptian army, the power of Pharaoh, to save the people of Israel. This day, the Easter Sunday, the Son of God, Jesus Christ, has destroyed the power of sin and death for all of us. For all of us now, the power of coronavirus is so powerful and so nasty that we in the whole world struggle. We don't know what to do with them. But I know for sure, in the near future, we will know how to deal with them. All the scientists and doctors and nurses will work together and figure out the cure to deal with the coronavirus. The coronavirus is powerful now, but will not the same. But for all of us, the nasty and the most powerful power we are afraid is the power of sin and death. We all sin, we all die. That is for sure. Nobody can run away from the power of death and sin. But Jesus Christ, our Savior, through His passion, death, and resurrection, have destroyed that nasty and most powerful power for all of us, to save all of us. Yes, that's what happened 2,000 years ago, and that's a great good news for all of us. But like the Israelite, we have a long journey to go. We are not in heaven yet. We are not in promised land yet. We have a long journey to go with all kinds of challenges and difficulties and tests waiting for us, especially during this time, when we stop, when we lose our freedom, when everything turned upside down. But we are the people continue to journey to heaven. If the Israelites have the column of fire to meet them, we have this column of fire that is the candle, the most important symbol during the Easter's time. That is the light of Christ. That is the light of the world that helps lead us through the darkness of our life. Whenever we need that light to lead us through our struggle, our darkness, go to the Bible. Go to the sacrament. In the Bible, the words of God is our light. In the sacrament, Jesus is the one who touched us, who empowered us, who raised us up, who walked with us, who being with us. And also in our personal prayer with Jesus, we invite Jesus to come to us. We want Jesus to have, we want to build a good relationship with Jesus. And when we have Jesus in our life, we have that column of fire. Shine forth for our journey. So friends, like the people of Israel, we have that column of fire shining forth for all of us during this time of challenge and test. Let us look up to that fire so we can see the direction. Let us come close to that fire. We will be protected. Let us embrace that fire that Jesus Christ in our life. We will raise it up. We will be empowered to continue to carry our own cross, very heavy during this time, to follow Jesus Christ closely. And we know, remember what St. Paul said, if we believe in Jesus, we will die with him. But it's not the end of our story. We will die with Jesus, and we will rise with him. That is the great good news. The good news that we all, Christians, embrace on this day. And that's the reason we can say to one another, Happy Easter. We can cry out with loud voice, this is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad.
Let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father, through him all things were made. For us men of our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit, we incarnate the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered for death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the rest of the dead, the life of the world to come. Christ our Savior, have conquered death, and intercede for us at the right hand of the Father. Let us bring our peace and those of the world before our risen Lord. pray.
For our world, may the light of the risen Christ cover our planet and dispel the darkness of disease, poverty, violence, and suffering. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those suffering from physical, mental, emotional, and spiritual illness, may Christ, the healer, bring comfort and hope. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are suffering as a result of this pandemic, including the families of those who are ill and have passed away, and for all healthcare workers, first responders, police, and service providers who are sources of healing and hope, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our St. Alphonsus community gathered in spirit, that through the renewal of our baptismal promises, we will be strengthened and purified to live as children of light. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those in our community who are unable to worship with us because of illness, and those in need of our prayers, and those mentioned in our book of petitions, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, especially Don Smith, husband of Joan, Charles Chuck Salka, father of Mark, and Elaine Rosano, and Pamela DeLeo. For all the intentions we hold in the silence of our hearts, and those we remember at this Mass, Jean Perkowitz, the Kutcher and Wurtz families, Rosemary and Michael Pavlov, George Fine, Tan Nguyen Nguyen, Michael Whaley, Jack Albert Tuffy, Aunt Mary Tuffy, John Hine, George Ryan, and Andrew Mueller. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Loving and merciful God, who raised your Son to new life, we ask that you hear the praise we offer. Through Christ our Lord.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good all this holy church.
And still then with Paschal gladness, O Lord, we offer the sacrifice by which your church is wondrously reborn and nourished through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but on this day above all, to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover hath been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who hath taken away the sins of the world. By dying has destroyed our death, and by rising restore our life.
gathering cowboys and chariot horse seem to gather the ending note of your glory and day of glad.
The mystery of faith.
Kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give
Deliver us both from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by thy hope and mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from our distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not at our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant them peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign.
Thank you. Let us pray.
Look upon your church, O God, with unfailing love and favor, so that renewed by the paschal mystery, she may come to the glory of the resurrection through Christ our Lord. Again, I would like to say happy Easter to all of you. May the risen Lord continue to bless and protect you and your family during this time of test. And I also want to take the time to say thank you all the people and staff who helped make this liturgy happen, especially to Wendy, Frank, and Mary, and Rosalyn. Special thank you to Woody. Woody is very busy recently with everything he's helped set up and work with Nancy and to do the wonderful decoration here. Thank you, Woody, for all the good work that you pour out during this time. May the reason for continue to bless you, give you a good health, and continue to serve the Lord to the end. Woody, 88 years old, but keep going every day to help me to set up for healing us. Thank you. So let us bow our hand and pray for God's blessing. May Almighty God bless you through today's Easter solemnity and in His compassion defend you from every assault of sin. Amen. And may He who restored you to eternal life in the resurrection of His only begotten endow you with the price of immortality. Amen. Now that the days of the Lord's Passover have drawn to a close, may you who celebrate the blessedness of Paschal Feast come with Christ's help and exulting in spirit to those feasts that are celebrated in joy, in eternal joy. And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you